Action!
A very special car for a very special film, directed by a very special man, Mr. Lewis Gilbert.
Oh,
sorry I was a little late on your cue there.
No, you were quite good, actually. You did very well coming round that corner, you know.
Now, you've given him a Lotus for the latest Bond film. What was wrong with the old Aston?
Well, there was nothing wrong with the old Aston, actually, but Lotus is really a car for today, isn't it? I mean, or tomorrow, and Bond films are about today and tomorrow.
All right.
Not yesterday, you know.
All right, well, now this one is fitted out like a kind of strategic nuclear weapon, isn't it?
Yes.
Did you just have the one car for all those effects?
Well, no, because really there were so many effects in this car that I don't think it could be embodied in a real car that Lotus is. So we had to have, obviously, three or four cars doing different things.
What, submarines and...
Yes, I mean, the basic thing that this car really turns into a submarine, you know, and which, incidentally, if you go to buy a Lotus, don't try diving into water because it may not happen for you.
They're not in production.
No, they're not in production. This is the only one that is a submarine.
Now, in that clip we've just seen, when the car takes off and goes into the water...
Real Lotus, actually, but it was the crossroad, there was nobody in it, there were dummies in it. The Lotus was catapulted, in fact. There was no engine in it.
I know you say it was a real Lotus. Did it get wrecked as a result of
that? Well, no, when I say it was a real Lotus, they actually take the engine out. So that the, you know, being catapulted, it needs to be lightweight.
That's true, I suppose it would.
And it was shot off by catapult, in fact.
Then there was the chase sequence. I gather that's a very long sequence in the film, isn't it?
Well, the whole sequence, the underwater and the chase on land, takes about 9 minutes, which probably makes it one of the longest chases, I should think, in film history.
Now, how long did that all take to shoot?
Well, the shooting is not the whole point of it. It's the planning of the thing, really, that takes the time. I mean, I suppose we would plan this chase for at least 9 months beforehand. The actual chase and the underwater probably took a month.
Just to get that, 9 minutes on the screen.
Yes, must have been.
Bond pictures are renowned for their ability to spend money. Indeed, behind us is the largest stage in the world, created just for this picture. Yeah. When the black car, for instance, goes over the edge, is that a real car?
Yes, again, it's a real car. I mean, the whole chase, of course, is with real cars. Again, they had to take the engine out of the black car, and then they put that over the side, over the cliff, for the same method. They catapulted over the edge. And you just hope that it's going to fall in the place that you want it to. You know?
Now, for all the people at home who can't even afford a new set of tyres, they own a car, wouldn't it have been easier to make a mock-up, or would it in fact have been more expensive than buying the real thing?
It's more expensive, really, to do a mock-up. It's a difficult thing to mock up a car that's going to do things, you know. I mean, it's much easier to take a car that's in production and...
And destroy it.
Yes, well, they don't destroy it, because Lotus help us out with things that we want in the car, you know, certain modifications that we can do. Well, that would be very difficult to do in a mock-up, you know, I mean...
All right. You're not a technical man, and I know this is a very far from standard model, but can you tell us some of the things that James Bond's Lotus can do?
Well, the main thing that this car does is to turn itself into a submarine, which is pretty unique, because, you know, there aren't many cars that can do that. This car manages it. I mean, the whole inside converts to the controls of a submarine. It tells you how deep you are. It's able to fire rockets the same way as a nuclear submarine does from underneath the water and shoot it out of the top.
So it's got surface-to-air missiles?
It has surface-to-air missiles as a submarine, yes. And then, of course, it's able to take avoiding action because an engine comes out at the back.
What about the armament? On the film clip earlier on, it was spewing some stuff out of the back.
Well, that's when it's on land. Of course, it's a totally... It is then almost like a normal Lotus, except at the back. It's able to squirt cement at the enemies from the back. In other words, four guns come out of the back and it's able to squirt the cement at people's windshields, which is, you know, I've often thought I would like that when I'm cut up on the road sometime, to have something like that.
Now, in the best Bond tradition, it's also got a computer inside with a targeting system, hasn't it?
Yes, same thing, which a lot of submarines have, of course. I hope I'm not giving away any top secrets. But it is computerized on the inside to fire these rockets, you see, and it's able to see through periscopes and see aircraft up above, and it's able to fire these rockets out of the car at the at the aircraft above.
Well, we're all lucky enough to be able to see the car today.
Yes.
When can we see the picture?
Well, I think it opens July the 7th. The opening of the film in England is July the 7th. And if you can get to New York, you can see it again about July the 21st.